Hello, wonderful people. Today, I'll be walking you through on how to create a general website using Blogger. Now, to do that, we'll talk about how to create a single website with Blogger, how to link it to a landing page, how to customize the post that is the write-up on your website, so that it's actually not show the date which the website, the write-up is created, and other things like that in our first video. So if you haven't gotten that step, make sure you get that step before you jump to this how to create a general website. Because the first one, how to create a website with Blogger, how to create a post, how to create a landing page, how to link the landing page to your main website, and how to customize other settings are in the first video on how to create Blogger. So now, you need to get that done first before you now come to how to create a general website with Blogger. Now, let's log on to our Blogger website, blogger.com. I've created another post added to the one we created before. This is the IBP. I'm actually trying to create a stretch mark website as well. So, I've not added any picture. But this one is still the one we created before. So why this one is the new one I'm creating. Now let us know how to create a general website. And what does the general website look like? For instance, this is a general website created with Blogger. This is FLP website. Organic Wellness Hub. This is a general website created using Blogger. This is success stories, that is stories of people that have used our products and they are testifying. And this is different kind of websites, like arthritis websites, diabetes, fibroid, IBP, infection, and so on. So now, this is what general website look like. I'm coming, let me show you another general website. Natural Awareness of. Yeah, this is another general website. It's still loading. This is another general website. So they have the same content in them, but different interface and different settings. So we can actually compare. You can see this is organic wellness up and this is natural wellness up. So now let's go back to our own website. Let's view our website and let's see the difference between our own websites and the other websites. You can see a single website with a particular landing page and some link websites as well. So now in order to go for a general website, what are the things you need to put in place? Number one thing is we need to know what is template. Template is just like theme, like the way they put it here on Blogger, theme. That is what we call template. Now Blogger has some theme here which are not suitable for creating a general website. They are not suitable, though you can use them, but they are not suitable for a general website. So now, like this, I actually customize this with another template. This is another template as well. So now to use your own template, all you need to do is log on to Google, then you search templates for Blogger. Okay, after you don't click on this, these are adverts. They actually don't have free templates except the one they're going to pay for. Okay, let me modify. Okay, this is it. Blogger template layout and theme for 20 for Blogger blog. Okay, let me click on this. So, wow, we have different kind of templates. You can see we have magazine, we have personal, we have photograph, we have portfolio, we have news, simple, and so on. So now you can just go down and check anyone who would like to use our. I think I like this. This SEO match. I think I like that. Okay, let me choose beauty blog blogger templates. Let me still check because I can still see another one more attractive than that. So actually you can actually check anyone later, but for the sake of the particular, you don't have to consume our data much, because the longer the video, the higher the data. So let me open this in a new tab. So now under this you can actually see the templates, and they are asking you, or you can download it, you can buy it, and you can check the demo, that is how it looks like. Now let's see what the template looks like by clicking on demo. Yeah, if you are using this kind of template, this is how it will look like on your blog. Okay, this is how it looks like, this is what it looks like, and I think this is very okay, especially for the kind of website you want to create. So let's download it and let's see how it looks like. What's wrong? Okay, it's not downloading. It has been downloaded. Okay, now that we have downloaded it, what are we going to do? What is the next thing that should be done after you have downloaded a template? Now, before we go to the template aspect, let me walk you through on something on Blogger. When you open your Blogger control panel like this, when you click on layout, let's go back to theme. Now you can see live on blog. This is the way your blog looks like. You can see it here, and this is mobile review. This is how it looks like on mobile phone. So now there are a lot of things you can actually adjust here. Now before we go into this deeply, let's click on edit HTML and let's see what happens. Wow, it's bringing out some codes which you may not understand. You can call it Jagos, but they're not Jagos, they're actually programming language, and they are tiring. When you are looking for one particular thing in the midst of all this, you now start looking like so. This particular code here is what is actually showing on our website here. This is where your website is constructed. This is what it has been used so that you can actually navigate on it easily. But in order to stress you much, we have customized it so that you can actually create your post easily without you using code. And so let's go back to theme. So we are clicking on edit HTML. HTML actually means hyperText markup language. So this is the code that is the programming language with which your website is made up of. Now we can change this so that we can actually change the way our website looks like. Now this is the template we downloaded. Let's open it. And if you are downloading all these templates, make sure you have either WinRAR on your laptop or your desktop computer or zip. These two, they are file opener. Okay, at times when you download a particular file, you are unable to open it, you can use WinRAR or zip, provided that those files are compatible with those two software I need mention of. So now this is the main template you downloaded. beauty blog free version. So when you open it, you can see it has all our code in it. So now, you just highlight all this code, highlight it, copy it, then go back to your browser. On your blogger from Companion under edit HTML, then highlight all this, clean them, remove it, then you paste the one you copied earlier, then save the thing. The moment you are done saving it, we need to save it again. Save theme again. Now let's see what happens to our website. Wow, something has happened here. You can actually see the welcome page has changed entirely. Now it has a lot of menu here, which is, I can call it label, I can call it menu. So now here we get to work. So this is the first step on how to create a general website. Now the next step is, after we are done saving the theme, then let's go to posts. Let's view the iBlog Treasure posts, that is the website is created for iBlog Treasure. Wow, look at what it looks like. Let's change it. Wow. So now what do we do next? What to do now is, you just go down to layouts. This is where you are going to edit all this beauty blog. And one thing about using free templates is that you may not be able to edit some things on your blog. You may not have Twitter access to it. Only if you are going to buy the template. That is when you are going to have Twitter access to everything here. But there are some templates that you are going to download that you have total access to them. It's just that we're not able to remove the footer and some other things. So now, what we need to do now that we have input another template is we just need to refresh this our browser. That is this particular tab. We need to refresh it so that all the other things can affect the other parts. Now, you can see this template, this layout is actually different from the one we edited earlier. And some of the ones we actually made not to be visible on the website are actually visible again. This is so because we actually input a new template. So now, what do we do now? Let's first change these labels. That is this menu we have up here. Let's first change everything here. It's actually linked list here. It shouldn't be linked list. It should be, okay, it's linked list. At times it will be main menu. At times it will be menu, depending on the kind of template you are using. So now, in a simple language, look at audio linked list here. Now let's leave the home. Now here is where you are going to change everything and edit. You can edit it, change the name they actually give it. Okay, now let me change this to success stories. Success stories. I'm going to save it. Then I'll scroll down. Now under this drop down one, I can write diabetes story. And one thing you need to notice under this is that this under it there is what we call. So now under it we can change this drop down one to what is it called? Let's change it to diabetes story. Diabetes story. Okay, now you can see URL, it has slash in it. We haven't linked it to anything. And I just need you to notice one thing. You can see this drop down two actually have underscore before the drop down two. Now I've removed that, which means the moment I remove it, all this This lockdown. Okay, lockdown one is now diabetes 2. Now, which means automatically, this lockdown 2 is under it. But a lot of people, don't let me twist it much. Let me save it and let's see what happens. So the moment you save it, refresh it here, and you are going to see the effect of what you just did. Look at it here. You can see success story. It has multiple drop down. Now the diabetes story will now have drop down 2, drop down 3, drop down 4. So now that is how to change it. It's actually linked list here. You know, I made mention of that. In some aspects, it will be menu. You can see we have main menu here. Okay, it's even main menu. So it's just the list. That is the list. Is what we call linked list. It's main menu. So I'm going to open it again. So now, under the, let me delete this main drop down. And under the story, I'm going to edit the other story. I'm going to put underscore. This underscore, you make it 2. No, make it 1. So it will now be under success story. So now I'm going to edit drop down 2 and make it. Arthritis story. I'm going to save it. Now, let me go down to where you can see short codes. Let me edit it and turn it to. Let me turn the short code to. Health solution. Let me save it. This one actually have this thing link to a particular website. So let me remove it and let me still put hash here. Okay, let me now save it. You actually link it to different websites later. But let's just do this way. Now that we've saved it, let's refresh it and let's see what's happened here. As you can see, Earth Solution, Sitemap, and Big Error Page is under it. Why this? We have Success Story, we have Diabetes Story. So now, what else? We are going, let's use this particular website method, Organic Wellness Up. Okay, we have Health Solution, we have Success Stories, we have About Us and Contact Us. So those are the four things we are going to use there. Since we are creating a health and wellness website, and we don't need to actually customize it like the website we are going to be updating every time. Once we have our post on it, we can only just edit the post, not that we will be adding more and more posts like normal daily bloggers. So now, what we need to do now is let's go back to the main menu, let's edit it. You see, that is actually the first thing we are doing here. So now, let's delete this download. Let's delete this. Okay, let me make it white. Let's delete video documentation. Okay, now. We are going to add one. In order to add one, this is what you just need to do. Contact us. Let's remove the link here first. That one is part of it. That is the page. Let's add it, and you can move it down. That is where you want it to be. Move it. Contact us. Now I'm going to put about us as, let me edit this documentation and put it as about us. So let me remove this link. Buddhist ash. We're going to change it later, but for the sake of the Vatican. So now other athletic story. Now let me show you one thing. You can see this underscore is double under drop down three. Why under athletics it is single. Now let me show you what that means on our main website. On our main website, let me show you what it looks like. Under success story, you can actually see that athletic story has also have another arrow, which means you can link one particular drop down menu to another drop down to another drop down like that, depending on whatever you are doing there. So now, so let's remove this drop down three. We don't need any arthritis, any drop down under arthritis story. So now we go back to under main menu, then edit this drop down three, make it single underscore, then change it to another story. Let's say fertility story. Fertility story. So let's save it. So this about us, let's change this error page, let's change it to IPP. Let's save it, let's remove this link. Don't forget, always remove all this, because we will change it later. So you save it. So let's edit this as well. Let's go down, change it to stretch mark. Stretch mark. Remove this link, put slash on hash, then save it. Then let's save it fully here. And let's check it on our website. Let's refresh our website. You can see it is now out of it. So back to work. It's like we have some error here. All this IPP and stretch mark are supposed to be under health solution. So what we are going to do is we go back to our main menu, edit it. So under the editing, you edit it, then you put underscore before health solution, save it. Under the IPP, you save it as well, put underscore, then you save it. Now save everything, then let's view it again. It will be back to normal. Yeah. There's still error. There's still error. Everything has now fallen under help solution. Another success story rather. So let's edit it again. Let me widen this. Okay. Help solution actually has underscore. Let me remove it. Save. So stretch mark does not have underscore before it. So remove it and save it. Then you save everything fully. Now it will be back to normal. So let's refresh it and let's see what happened. Oh, that means we are done with linking this. So now to link other posts, just save this. Save it, go back to your post. Now this is high blood pressure right on next on website. So let me open it. What you just need to do is, this is the main writer. Just highlight this particular link, copy it, then go to your layout again. Under the main menu link list, you edit it, click on edit button, then scroll down to where you can actually see IPP, edit it. Now where you have your hash, remove it, then paste the websites, IBP websites, save it, then you save it again. Now let's refresh it here. Now we refresh the website. Now let's click on IBP. You can see it has been linked to that particular write-up, but if you should click on stretch mark, nothing is going to happen. This is so because we haven't linked it to any website. So what do? We go to our post again, then you view the stretch mark solution, then highlight the link here, copy it, then go back to your control panel in Blogger, go to layout, under the main menu, click on the pencil icon which we use to edit, then scroll down where you can see stretch mark, click on edit here, scroll down, then remove this hash, paste the link to your stretch mark website, save it. Make sure you save so that you won't actually be having issue with it. Now let's reload it again. Now let's click on stretch mark. Wow, it has been linked. But if you should notice something up here, we have IBP Natural Cure, IBP Cure on our tab. The reason is that under when we're creating it, the title we gave to the website is IBP Cure. So when you want to change the title, just go to settings, then you click on edit, then change it to, let's change it to Natural Remedy. Then you save it. Now let's refresh this. You see, it's not showing Natural Remedy. The reason why when you click on home, it's showing welcome is because the title of this page is welcome. Okay, so now we can go on and remove. Under the page, you can go on and remove the title of that landing page. Let's remove it, which is welcome. Let's update it. So let's view it again. You see, it's now showing Natural Remedy on the tab, which means anybody opening your website, logging onto your website for the first time, they are going to see Natural Remedy. And that is how to link different kind of write-up. Now to create your success story, you create it like normal post, then you link it to this one. And about us, you create a page. You create a new page here. Create a new page. We are health consultants. Consultants. Let me just save this as practical, a practical purpose that won't take much time. Then you view it. Now this is the landing page. Just highlight the link here, Control L, then you Control C to copy. Then you go to your layout. You see, under the layout, that's where you are going to complete almost everything on that website. Almost everything, I repeat again, on that website. So now, go to your main menu, edit it, then under the About Us, edit it, where you can see hash, remove the hash, and paste the About Us page, save it, then save fully. Now, one thing, okay, let me do this first. Let's refresh it. So now, when you click on About Us, you see, we are health consultant. Now, one thing you need to take note of is that when you are creating a page, you need to name the page. The reason being that so that when somebody is opening a page, you know that they are opening a page. Now, you can just put About Us. About Us. Then, you put a dash, then you put your Natural, that is your website, Natural Remedy. Then you save it. you update it, you see about us, natural remedy. So this one, welcome. You update it. Now when you click on this home again, the welcome will now be welcome natural remedy. It's loading. It should be okay. This is not fully saved. That is due to service. Okay, let's reload it again. You see, it's not showing welcome now. The about us will not be about us, natural energy, you see. So that's how you go about it. So this is how to link different particular websites to the general website and how to make some other settings. So now, to remove all these other settings here, let's get back to work. The main thing we need, now that I've worked with you on how to create all this, now what you need to consider is removing some other things on this particular website. You can see, because we're actually using free templates, it's showing beauty blog, elegant and beauty blogger templates and others. We don't really need all this. So let me walk you through on how to remove this. Go to your control panel. Under the control panel, just go to layouts. Now you need to remove a lot of things here under layouts. These outposts, let me actually remove this landing page. Let me remove it. You go to settings. That's what I said. If you have not watched, if you have not practiced the first video, you have not capitalized on it, you need to go back to it and work with the first video that you can actually get whatever I'm doing right now. So I want to remove the welcome page, that is the landing page. I want to remove it. So now I'll go to settings, under search preference, custom redirect. I'll click on edit. Then what I'm going to do is delete this. Then you save. So now when you delete it, let me click on this again. It will not show that welcome page again. You can actually show posts on your website. So there are a lot of things we can still do here that will make, like this one, this particular picture here, this particular image here that's not fully showing, it's actually not a write-up itself, but it's groups of write-up, that is group of posts on your website. Now let's go back to layout and continue from there, which we call it now let's, all these bust version, let's remove them. Delete it. Save. You will see the effect here. You see? What again? Default variables. Let's discuss all these default variables. Let me show you what it means here. When you open any of these posts, oh, it's actually not showing, maybe it's not fully loaded. That discuss is just like your, it's just like comments, which we have unchecked in the first listing. So what you just need to do is make sure you delete all these, delete, then you make it not to be visible. You save it. So let's see its effects. Actually, different kind of template has different kind of options there. So if you are going to create a general website, you need to take your time in order to do this. Now header logo, let's remove that, which is actually this beauty blog that is showing on our website, which we don't need. Let's remove it. So I'm going to show header logo, show page header, remove it. then remove this particular image, then you save. Now when you save it, refresh this and let's see what happened. Oh ho, the image is gone. The image is gone. Okay. So now, let's go back to home. Let's go back to home. So, let's view the website, and it seems we are still having this here, and we don't need this. We actually want our laptop only. So HTML, this outpost, this is it. So let's remove it. So we are removing the outpost. Let me remove it. So let me refresh it. Let me refresh this and let's see what happens. Oh, the outpost is gone. The outpost is gone. So all this one on this site, I want to actually remove them. All this footer, I want to remove them. So just start clicking on them one after the other, then we remove. Click on popular posts. We remove it. Okay, I'm using this to avoid distraction on our website. Click on Facebook. Okay, you can link your Facebook page to this. All you just need to do is copy a kind of this thing link here or from your Facebook and paste it here. So that's what you just need to do. Your Facebook page, you copy it, then you paste it here. So I'm removing this as well. The categories, let's remove all this. The moment we are removing it, it will save automatically. Anyone that is not removable, that does not show any remove button, just make it not to be visible. Remove. Tags, remove it. This one that can actually be dragged from one part to another, you can remove them. But the one that does not have any option like this that you can be able to drag, all you just need to do is you make it not to be visible, but it will be there. It is not visible on your website. Remove recent posts. Remove everything here. You don't want all this social media with gets. Remove them only if you want to link them to you want to link your website to your Facebook, your Twitter, your Pinterest, and your Instagram page. So this one cannot be removed, so you can make it not to be visible. Yeah, so we are making it not to be visible, and you save it. It's actually there, but it's not visible on your website. So what else do we need to customize here? Let's check. Now let's open, okay, let's refresh it. You can see all these popular posts, Facebook, all this, and so on. And let me refresh the website. Maybe it's going to show up. Wow, they are all gone, which means we have total control of this particular template. That's a very good thing. So I think this marks almost the end of the training, but we still need to check some other things here. Let's open IBP here. You can see it's actually showing the date this particular light up is created, and we don't want that. You know, if you are creating a new website and you want to sell, some people may actually visit the website to see maybe it has been long you are running the business, or you just launched into the business and you want to start making sales. They might actually not believe in your this thing, in your products. But when you don't see the date, so we can actually edit that under main posts. All these things are still under layout. So you click on the main posts. So don't forget to uncheck all these by, uncheck everything. The moment you uncheck everything, then you save it, scroll down, and save it. So the moment you save it, let's view it and let's see what happens. Oh ho! Wow, we have total control over this particular template. So this marks the end of how to create a general website. What else do I need to just add that can actually give you this thing? And the last thing here is, if you want to delete your blog, it's very easy to delete your blog. Just go to settings, then under order, you click on order, you can see delete blog here. So when you click on delete, it will prompt you to download the blog. So that when if you feel like not deleting the blog, you can actually download the data on the blog. So this marks the end of our training on how to create blogger website. Make sure you personalize, pause and play this video in case you are not getting it right. Play it again and again, and the more you work on it, the more you will get it. So thank you for paying attention, thank you for listening, thank you for watching, and for those of you who are just getting the academy, I wish you best of luck. Let us meet at Bahamas 2020 and Sydney, Australia, which is Global Rally. So I pray for more CC and more success to your week. Let us soar high like the way eagles soar high in the sky. So have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.